Today we will be discussing about applications of Schrodinger's equation to one and three dimension problem. First we will discuss about the free particle. Now the Schrodinger wave equation for a free particle of mass m and total energy E and potential energy V, this is written as del 2 psi plus 2m upon h cross square into E minus V psi, this is equal to 0, where h cross is as usual h upon 2 pi, where h being the Planck's constant. A free particle is one for which potential energy V is quite independent of potential, quite independent of position, and hence for convenience it may be set equal to 0. So that the Schrodinger wave equation for a free particle becomes del 2 psi plus 2m upon h cross square into E psi, this is equal to 0, or in Cartesian coordinates we can write it as del 2 psi plus del 2 psi upon del x square plus del 2 psi upon del y square plus del 2 psi upon del z square plus 2m into h cross square E psi, this is equal to 0. This is a partial differential equation in three independent variables x, y and z, and this may be solved by the method of separation of variables imposing the boundary condition, that is psi is finite everywhere in space since the particle is free to move anywhere in space. So that we may write the solution of equation 3 in the form psi, this is equal to capital X, which is a function of X, into capital Y, which is a function of Y, and capital Z, which is a function of Z. These X, capital X, capital Y, and capital Z are functions of their respective coordinates alone. Now, substituting this in equation del 2, Cartesian coordinates equation, del 2 psi upon del x square plus del 2 psi upon del y z square plus del 2 psi upon del z square plus 2m upon h cross square E psi, this is equal to 0, we will get 1 upon x, and also divided by it by capital X into capital Y into capital Z, we may get 1 upon x del 2x upon del x square plus 1 upon y del 2y upon del y square plus 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square plus 2m upon h cross square E, this is equal to 0. Now this equation may also be written as 1 upon x del 2x upon del x square plus 1 upon y del, this is equal to minus 1 upon y del 2y upon del y square minus 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square minus 2m upon h cross square E psi. In this equation, left hand side is a function of x alone, while right hand side is a function of y and z and is independent of x. It is therefore necessary that the value of the quantity to which each side must be independent of x, y, z, that is both sides must be equal to constant kx, so that 1 upon x del 2x upon del x square is equal to kx, and also right hand side also is equal to kx. We can write minus 1 upon y del 2y upon del y square minus 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square minus 2m upon h cross square E, this is also equal to k square. Now equation 8, again by this equation we can write 1 upon y del 2y upon del y square minus kx minus 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square minus 2m upon h cross square E. So again, left hand side is independent of z, while right hand side is independent of y. Therefore, if function equation is the above equation is to be satisfied, both sides must be equal to a constant, suppose ky, so that 1 upon y into del 2y upon del y square is equal to ky. So the equation will become minus kx minus 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square minus 2m upon h cross square E, this is equal to ky. So equation 11 will become 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square is equal to minus kx minus 2m upon h cross square E minus ky. In above equation, right hand side is a constant. Let this constant be equal to, suppose, kz. So this is also equal to kz, and right hand side is also equal to kz. So we can write 1 upon z del 2z upon del z square is equal to kz, and minus kx minus ky minus 2 upon h cross square e, this is also equal to kz. Or we can say that kx plus ky plus kz is equal to minus 2m upon h cross square e. Now for our convenience, let us substitute kx is equal to 2m upon h cross square ex. So the differential equation will become del 2x upon del x square plus 2m upon h cross square ex, ex is equal to 0. Now this is a general equation, and the solution of this equation will be xx is equal to nx sine under root 2m upon ex h cross into x minus x0, where nx and x0 we have taken as arbitrary constants. Similarly for y and z, we can write equation del 2y upon del y, del y square plus 2m upon h cross square ey, ey, y is equal to 0, and del 2z upon del z square plus 2m upon h cross square ez, z is equal to 0. So solution of above equation, as in the, as we have seen in the case of x, we can write capital Y is equal to ny sine under root 2m ey upon h cross y minus y 0, and capital Z is equal to nz sine 2m under root 2m ez upon h cross z minus z 0. Now substituting this value of kx and ky and kz, we get ex plus ey plus ez is equal to k. So the eigen or wave function or characteristic function and energy values of the particle are psi is equal to capital X into capital Y into capital Z. We have calculated capital X, capital Y and capital Z. Therefore, where n we have taken as nx into ny into nz, and e is equal to ex plus ey plus ez. Clearly the free particle has a continuous set of energy level, hence the however the quantization may occur if the particle is not completely free, but it is constant to remain a box, which we shall consider next article. The complete wave function will be psi is equal to x, y, z, t. X we have calculated, y we have calculated, z is equal to calculated, and t is iota minus so this e is minus e raised to minus iota et upon h cross. So this is the complete wave solution of the above equation. Thank you.